I got loyalty, got royalty inside my DNA. Cocaine quarter piece, got war and peace inside my DNA. I got power, poison, pain, and joy inside my DNA. I got hustle, though, ambition, flow inside my DNA.
Yo, what's up, everybody? It's your boy Sean B. Nice back again with some more Heat Rock, and that's promised and delivered, yo. Here's the Dex Station versus the new Dex Pad. Let's see if it's worth the money. But I kind of think y'all already got my answer from last video, but let's check it out anyway. All right, guys, so here we go with the comparison video, and now we're going to be testing out the Dex Pad functionality versus the actual Dex. And the first Dex we're starting off with is the original Dex Pad. The original Samsung Dex that came out in 2017, and now we have 2018 model over here. But since all of the cores and everything is the same, it's just easy for me to disconnect the older cores and put them into the other devices and whatnot. But nonetheless, before we get started, I definitely want to give a huge shout out to one of my subscribers. Make sure I zoom in so you guys check his name out on Instagram. Is TS.Slavov. He's the one who actually gave me the idea to change and tweak some settings real quick to kind of make Dex a little bit better. Now, if you guys saw my original Samsung Dex Pad review, I wasn't really impressed with it. I doubt if I'm gonna be impressed with this one, but we will see. But first, I kind of want to just go here and show you guys the option he showed me with the Dex Labs. You want to go to Samsung Dex, double click it, and you want to make sure you have Dex Labs actually on, okay? Now, the only real differences between these two devices is honestly the Ethernet port. Because actually, if you look at the original box of the Samsung Dex, it is capable of portraying or displaying 4K on these monitors. So I was kind of confused on why they kept pushing the fact that the new Dex Pad can do 4K. Because if I remember correctly, this one could. So I was a little surprised by that. Maybe it's just a selling gimmick or whatever the case is. But other than that, those are the only two huge differences between the two devices. The original Dex has the Ethernet port and the Dex Pad does not. So if we're talking about just a few differences between ports, I don't really know if that's worth a purchase, especially if you already have a Dex. But nonetheless, what I kind of wanted to show you guys, just a little bit more in-depth look of Dex itself. So now when we go to Instagram, I'm able to scroll through with the actual scrubber now. You know, that was the issue for me last time. Go back here. And we're able to scrub through now. We can take a look at Microsoft Word. Let's go ahead and expand this out. Now, this is what I was talking about when I say the Dex may be the perfect device for if you have a high school student or maybe a kid that's in grammar school, like 7th or 8th grade or something like that. They can just easily plug this device up to their phone and have the entire desktop experience no problem. So here, as you guys can see, I'm able to highlight certain things. If I wanna copy this here, got Control C. Let's see if Control V works. Control V works. So actual keyboard functions still work on this. If I wanna hit Control Z and delete what I just did and put it back, you can do that. So now we're starting to cook a little bit, okay? Right now, that's still worth $60. You know, is this worth $100 still? I'm not there yet. I cannot sit there in front of this camera and say you guys, yeah, it's worth $100 now. Not because of a couple of features like that, but here's some data charts that I did when I was in college still. You know, nothing too crazy, but nonetheless, it is fluid still. We right click, we can change the colors on the tabs itself. You can make this one blue. And as you guys can see, it actually changed the color. So we have bar chart in blue, line chart 2 in red. So again, so far, I mean, it's looking good. I mean, now all apps are not optimized for this, obviously, right? So like YouTube Studio will not be optimized for it. Let's go ahead and close this down. Cause I was actually able to sign into my Microsoft account with no problems and everything was working just fine. Let's go ahead and close this out. Let's look at some other apps, look at the internet still. Again, I kind of don't want to rehash over the same thing. The main thing of this video was to kind of go back and touch some things that I probably would have missed on the Dex Pad now that I had Galaxy Labs on. And all right, guys, so as you guys can see from the video, I wasn't going to make this video all drown out too much, man. Look, it's very simple. You have the new Dex Pad that's going for $100. The only difference between that Dex Pad and the original Dex Pad is the Ethernet port. But if you're using Wi-Fi most of the time, especially in a hotel, do you really need the Ethernet port? That's number one. Number two, that on the Dex Pad, you can actually lay the phone down to use it as a mouse. And in the original Dex, the phone is propped up, but you can still use it a mouse. Is it as conventional as the phone laying down? No, but then again, you also have a mouse. So you have to ask yourself this. If you already have a, well, first of all, it's no brainer. If you have an original Dex, do not upgrade to the Dex Pad. There's no need for it. And number two, you know, is this device for you? Either one of these devices. So, cause so far for me, they're not for me, but then again, I'm not in school anymore. I've already graduated college, I'm no longer in high school. So the Dex doesn't really benefit me in my everyday life. But again, as I stated in my last video, the Dex is really a great option for kids that are still in school. It's, to me, it's even better than a Chromebook because you're only spending an extra $100. Heck, if you get the original Dex, you're only spending maybe $50 to $40. I got my original Dex for $50 on B&H Used. Okay, so you can get the original Dex right now for $50 versus you're going to spend $100 on a Dex Pad that takes more functionality away from it because now you don't have an Ethernet port anymore. So again, those are questions you got to ask yourself. But to me, I can straight look dead into this camera and tell you, if you have a laptop or if you have maybe a tablet or anything like that, the Dex is not worth the buy as of yet. It's just the functionality of it. I mean, if you have a laptop, it's really no point for it. Like, unless you're just a Samsung diehard fan, cool, you go out, you spend your money the way you want to. But if you're a person who has a laptop already, this is not for you. If you're a person that has a tablet, maybe with even a keyboard, this is not for you. If you're a person who needs something a little bit more powerful than, you know, this is not for you. But if you're a high school student, maybe a college student, depending on what you're going to college for, maybe just, you know, business courses, things like that, where, you know, the main core of computer for you right at that point is Microsoft Word and Microsoft Excel and PowerPoints, then cool, this is for you. This is a student's like gift bag. This is the grab bag gift you want to give for a kid, a college party, throwing away, whatever the case is. They got a Samsung device. That's the device. That's the accessory you want to get them out of anything else. So, you know, if they don't have a tablet, don't even waste your money on buying a tablet because you can go ahead and use your phone for that. And boom, there you go. So if this video helped you out, man, and it kind of made everything, you know, if I kept everything straight, you know, to the point, if you actually value my opinion, if this helped you save some money, let me know, man. Please give me that thumbs up button. Make sure you subscribe to the channel. But I will also make sure I link down the both of these products down in the description below. If you got any more questions, I definitely respond to all my comments on my, you know, on my videos. So it's your boy, Sean B. Nice, man. I'm out. Deuces.